People of Earth, how are you? Welcome to episode 31 of the House Arrest Concert Series with me, your host and sole performer, Bill Spence. Happy to have you with me. Thank you very much for taking time out of your busy Saturday nights. It's a beautiful day. It's literally 75 degrees outside this afternoon. It's a beautiful day for a beautiful day. I actually do have champagne, but I'm going to let that sit and go with my regular liver tonic because I don't want to be switching up in the middle of a set. An historic day. An historic day all around. Joe Biden, Kamala Harris. There will be dogs back in the White House in January. Scout and Major, both German Shepherds, both rescues, I think. And that's cool. This day in history, in 1944, FDR clinched his fourth term as president. In 1972, Richard Nixon got his second term as president. 1989, David Dinkins became the first black mayor of New York City. First black governor of Virginia, Douglas Wilder. That happened in 1989. I'm getting lots of data. Oh, in 1916, Jeanette Rankin, the first woman elected to the House of Representatives from Wyoming. She was a progressive Republican. So, like I said, an historic day all the way around. 9 Feels like America has woken up in bed with Suzanne Pleshette. Sure you don't know. Yeah, you don't know what the hell I'm talking about there. But, you know, that's just me. I was actually feeling like I should call the doctor. Isn't that the thing? If your election lasts more than 4 days, you're supposed to call the doctor. I don't know, maybe that was just something I heard somebody with an MD from Facebook University. I wonder if they're going to continue giving them out. I know they're still handing out the political science degrees like junior mints, but who knows. On this date, November 7th, in 1867, was born Marie Curie, the first woman to be awarded a Nobel Prize. My dad, William Edward Spence, was born in 1912 on this date. So he would be 108 and as irascible as ever. And in 1943, in Canada, this artist. Bows and flows of angel hair, and ice cream castles in the air, and feather canyons. I've looked the clouds that way, now they only block the sun. It rain and snow on everyone. So many things I could have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked the clouds from both sides now, from up and down.
hell. It's clouds, illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel, as every fairy tale comes real. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go, and if you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions I recall. I really don't know love at all. Tears and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way. But now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. But something's lost and something's gained. Living every day, I look at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life at all. Now, from up and down, and still somehow, it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life.
From Joni Mitchell. That is number 170 on Rolling Stone's list of the 500 greatest songs of all time, which I take issue with, but I'll talk about that in a minute. Both Sides Now was written allegedly in 1968. However, there exists a recording from 10 days from now in 1966, from 11-17-1966 at the Second Fret Club in Philly, where Joni Mitchell sang this song. So that kind of goes against the theory that it was written in 1967. But anyway, it was a 68 single for Judy Collins on her Wildflowers album, and it was on Joni Mitchell's album named Clouds, 1969. So that's, like I said, number 170 on Rolling Stone's Best Songs of All Time, and I decided to do those this evening, and then I started looking at that list, which is pretty bogus, to tell you the truth. I mean, it's very self-serving. The number one is Bob Dylan's Like a Rolling Stone, which, yeah, okay, classic song, not the best song ever. Number two is the Rolling Stones performing Satisfaction, Yeah, another great song, but not the number two song of all time. So Jan Wenner, like, bite me. Anyway, I'm gonna go check the recording device and make sure I can stand up, because I'm gonna have to do that eventually. Hang on. Oi! Yes, I still haven't recovered my back. Okay, half do know what I'm talking about. I'm not sure what that is, but I'll check that out later. Rob Generelli is watching. Terry Wilson is watching. That's great. Thanks, folks. I'm sure you can all catch it on the replay, those who aren't watching. But those who aren't watching, then, well, they're not hearing what the hell I'm saying anyway. So, thanks for those who are there. Thanks for democracy. Thanks for the initial shift of the universe out of retrograde. And that's it. That's all I have to say about that. So next one. Yeah, I got all my notes on my Today in History crap taken care of. Next one is number 41 on that Rolling Stone list.
Thank you.
Big Jack, my dog. I said, oh, wait a minute, Chester. You know I'm a peaceful man. He said, that's okay, boy. Won't you feed him when you can? Take a load off Fanny. Take a load for free. Take a load off Fanny. Here's one, number 188 on that list from Creedence Clearwater Revival.
Long as I remember, rain been coming down, clouds of mystery pouring, confusion on the ground. Good men through the ages, trying to find the sun. And I wonder, still I wonder, who'll stop the rain? Shelter from the storm. I caught up in the fable. I watched the tower grow. 5-year plans and new deals wrapped in golden chains. And I wonder, still I wonder, who'll stop the rain?
Number 188 on the Rolling Rolling Stone's list of 500 greatest songs ever. So, believe them if you want. All right. Moving along here. Drop down 8 slots to number 176. This is one I've done before. So, I had to do that. Business doing. People asked me if I was going to do no. But, you know, I'm feeling it. It's playing in my head. This last one is an original number by Tom Foy, my friend of 40-odd years and collaborator on many things. This is one of the nicest things, I believe, that Tom and I worked on, and he agrees. Whether I can do it justice, well, that remains to be seen. It's called Will-O-Wisp. Like a will-o-wisp, our love. Like crossing the sun on the bare of your feet. Like lying to yourself that there's no need, our love. Like a will-o-wisp, our love.
trick of the light, a howl from Noah's on a moonless night. You start to run, but it's just out of sight. Like feeling a chill when no breeze has blown, like a flash of someone when you're alone. Our love, like a will-o'-wisp, love. It's a will-o'-wisp, a trick of the light, a shadow past the corner of your eye. You start to look, but it's just outside. Tug on the heart when they aren't there, like a feeling you have when you're not scared. Our love, like a will-o'-wisp, love. It's a will-o'-wisp, a trick of the light, a shadow past the corner of your eye. You start to look, but it's just out of sight. A will-o'-wisp, a trick of the light, a shadow past the corner of your eye. You start to look, but it's just outside.
Thanks for joining me. Coming up on 8 o'clock. Go watch your TV. Although there's nothing worth obsessing about on TV now that things have been called. But I, for one, am happy for the return of sanity and civility and vocabulary, at least. Three same things that we've been missing for quite some time. And that is all I'm going to say about that. So until next time, episode 32, I bid you adieu and ciao, ciao. Yes, I seriously need the cane.